But we're going to start to take off the exhaust. It's not factory, it's a custom exhaust, and I don't have a hair tie, so look what I'm resorted to. Cable tie. See if I can make this work. Didn't break your machine, did it?
No.
Yeah, it worked. You guys closer. May not do much for safety, but at least I'll look cool.
You see where I cut that out?
Right here?
Mm-hmm.
Just go through that.
Don't try cutting in here at the weld, because okay. That's hard and it won't cut it. Cut right beside it. Cut all the way through that. Push that.
Push
this all the way up to that, because it will
like that?
Do like that. That's that.
Got it off. All right, so I'm going to cut right through there.
Mm-hmm. Same thing on the other side. Oops. That was a video on the ground.
Okay, so where is the next one?
Next one's right there.
Right there. Let me put this here somewhere. Sorry, where did you say? Right here?
Yeah, just opposite of the other one that you just cut, right behind that well. The other way. Spin it around. Teeth to it. There you go. Come back this way. Right in here.
The exhaust off and then the other way.
Back half.
Now the front half. Okay. Just feel this fine? It's a bit bent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, to be honest.
It's hot. Oh yeah, maybe I'll just hold it like this.
Yeah. Yeah, just don't get these.
Yeah.
Transmission lines. We're not going to use, but you still
the table for a moment?
Oh.
If I hit those cables.
Mm-hmm. Close. Come on this side now. Come right in there. You can see your cut. Try to lay that right in that cut. Right, about right there.
There?
Mm-hmm. To come this way. Straighten this up. That's your I'm not using that either, but it's your brake line.
Oh, my brake line, okay.
Give me the hammer and see if I can straighten this blade up. Just about toast.
I can smell it.
Just a little bit right there.
I'm going to get this other table where I might need them.
That was it. Right there. Got to cut them loose right here now.
Hopefully our blade lasts us.
Let me see it. I might get us a new one.
So what happens to these other parts that are still on here?
That's the exhaust manifolds.
Okay.
They'll come out with the engine.
Right.
The rest of that will. We would have just took it apart and kept it intact, but I might let this try to cut it. Well, let me see what it looks like. Come up this way with it. Try to cut it right through there.
Okay. To take it off those two little things?
Yeah, we just want to cut this in two where it'll separate from the...
Right there?
Try to come up right in there and cut through the metal and not the weld.
Oh,
like
okay,
that.
Okay, yeah.
That weld's so hard it would just ruin that weld.
There's a cable there.
You're going. You're still good. Being into that cable. You talking about this one?
Yes.
Yeah, it's fine.
It's fine.
I'm watching it. Hang on. Get back in that cylinder right there. called a sawzall.
A sawzall?
Or a reciprocating saw, either or.
A sawzall.
A lot of people call it reciprocating saw, but it's a sawzall.
A sawzall, yeah. Reciprocating saw.
Yep.
Never used one before, but I like it.
Use one now.
Never have, but now I have. Hey, that wasn't too bad taking the exhaust out.
No, it wasn't bad. We'll drain the antifreeze out of that radiator next.
All right.
Front end.
We're going to lower this baby and then take a look at that radiator and learn how to drain the fluid. Never done that before either. Don't think there'll be anything that I can say. I've done this before.
No.
I leave this on the ground just here.
Yeah, I'll be fine.
What are you fiddling with?
It's called a petcock, and it's a little, you see it right there?
Yeah.
It's that's how you drain the antifreeze out of it.
Just by that one little mechanism there?
Yeah, but it's awful slow. We might go a different route, but we'll look at it.
Okay. Obviously, we're getting rid of the radiator.
Mm-hmm.
Now we have to drain it before we can take it off, because if we didn't drain it and somebody just takes it off,
be all over everything.
It just goes over everything.
All over the floor, everywhere. Yeah.
Because as soon as you unlatch it, it starts to come out.
As soon as you take them hoses, radiator hoses loose, mm-hmm. they just start gushing antifreeze out everywhere.
Oh wow, okay.
And it's hard to contain it when it's that much fluid coming out at one time. And that's why I was gonna try to drain this, and it may or may not work. We might have to take the hose off anyway.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of times that things get.
So you just turn that, like
mm-hmm.
a little tap,
mm-hmm.
and then where is the fluid actually coming from?
Out of the hole in the middle of it.
Oh.
See right there?
Oh,
that
that's
part.
Where it's all coming from.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what nest did you say?
Dirt collar.
What's that?
It's a bee that makes a nest out of mud.
Huh?
It's called a dirt collar. It looks like a wasp bird, but it's black. And it uses mud. It goes and gets dirt that's been saturated in water, and it makes nest where it lays its eggs for its babies. It makes it out of mud, really, like a mud hut.
Isn't that interesting?
So, you know, it don't drain super quick because it's just a little bitty hole, but you just drain the fluid right out of that petcock. It's called a petcock.
Petcock. Mm-hmm. There's all that green fluid.
Mm-hmm. Don't want a dog that's making drinking that.
No.
That's got to drain.
How long would it take, depending on how much is inside it?
Yeah, it's probably a gallon and a half to 2 gallons inside a normal size radiator. My brother-in-law said, "You want that?" He thought that over one day. Said, "You want this?" And I said, "I don't know what I'd use it for."
There you go.
Found to be useful for something.
Who would have known that I would be right here in your shop, and this is where it's going to get used for, to drain the fluid of my radiator.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Thank you.
So what do you call this, the grill holder or?
This is the radiator support.
Radiator support.
Yeah, radiator core support.
Might need to hold it up.
Well, he was right.
Those bolts need to be cut?
Yep, that one does.
This one doesn't look too good.
Let's see if it'll come like this. That one's got to be cut too. There's no way to hold the top, so it just spins. So the head of it?
Yep.
It's not got anything that you could put a wrench on.
So how are you going to cut it? Using the angle grinder?
Yeah, right here we'll go in and cut that off there. This one right off there. And then just
and that's it.
Off and then get two new ones to put it back on.
All right.
So we can save that for another day if you want.
Yeah, we'll start off with that on Monday night.
Yeah. Well, I can get this all out of here and drain it out.
And then after that, we'll look at taking off the cab.
Cab
and then
it's frame chassis.
So how is the cab connected?
Four bolts.
Oh, those are those big bolts.
You want to see them?
I think you showed it last time. I can't remember.
Right here is one.
Oh, yes.
One at the front on each side and one at the back on each side.
And now, but these things here.
Four of them. That'll come off with it. All this comes off with the cab.
And they stay on the cab?
Mm-hmm. They stay with it until we get ready to blast it. We'll disassemble, blast it, and put the parts back with it. But basically...
And the engine is just sitting on the frame?
Yeah, it's just sitting. All that's just sitting on the frame. So this will just lift straight off the frame. This will come off with the cab. That'll come off with the cab.
This will come off with the cab?
Everything else stays on the frame.
Okay, and all these wires and stuff, well, they're all disconnected here anyway,
mm-hmm.
except for this one.
Yep, we'll disconnect the rest of them.
Mm-hmm.
Pigtails, unplug them, whatever we got to do.
They're the starter cables, aren't they?
You got your generator, starter, air conditioner, all that stuff's in these wirings. This is all headlights. Everything runs across the front, your horns, your headlights. All that stuff, but that goes over to the alternator and starter. This one goes to the alternator.
I want to put a coil horn on this.
A coil horn?
Yeah, something different. All right, it's going good.
Yep.